This is part two of function transformations. In this part two, I'm going to talk about stretches, shrinks, and reflections. I strongly recommend that you watch part one first. So here's part two, stretches, shrinks, and reflections, coming right up. Let's talk about a vertical stretch or a vertical shrink. So in this case, we have A multiplied by f of x, and you'll notice that this is outside the argument of the function. It's multiplying the y value, so it's just impacting the y value. And if we multiply y by a number greater than 1, we're going to stretch it. It's, if you multiplied me by 2 vertically, you'd pull me up 2, I'd be much taller and thinner. What about if you multiplied me by a number between 0 and 1? So let's say you multiply me by 1/3. Then I'd be 1/3 my height. I'd be very, very small. So let's have a look. So if I have to explain what happens here, I would first note that this is outside the argument of the function for part A, and it's impacting the y coordinate. So it's a vertical stretch because it's greater than 1. And the new points instead of xy would become x2y. Now for the part B, this is a vertical shrink or a vertical compression. They're both the same thing. It's shorter for me to write shrink, so that's what I'm going to write. And this is x, and the y, it just impacts the y coordinate. It's 1/3 times y. Let's see what that looks like now. So here's my original function, and I'm going to make a 2 times. So notice it's going to grow a by 2. Next, let's do a vertical shrink. So we're going to do just 1/3. So we're going to make a 1/3 or 0.33. And you'll notice that we have a vertical shrink. It's as though we've got an invisible bar on the top and an invisible bar on the bottom pushing on our blue graph to vertically shrink it. Now we want to talk about, inside the argument of the function, a horizontal stretch or shrink. Notice what we're looking at here is y equals f input b of x. So it's inside the argument of the function. It's going to impact the x coordinates, kind of the opposite of what our brain wants. So if I'm multiplying the x value by some value greater than, in absolute value than 1, we'd like that to be a stretch, but it's not. It's a shrink. Remember, we have to think, what do we have to do to get back to x? We divide it by b or multiply it by 1 over b. Same thing if we have if b is fractional, so if the absolute value of b is between 0 and 1, the graph is stretched by b. So in this example for part A, we have, because it's inside the argument of the function, we have a horizontal compression by 2. Horizontal compression. I know it's horizontal because it's impacting the x coordinate. And it's a shrink, if you like. So it's, imagine you have this invisible bar pushing from the right and another invisible bar pushing from the left. That's going to squeeze it or shrink it horizontally. And our new points would become, well, it only impacts the x coordinate. What do I have to do to 2x to get it back to x? It's 1/2 times x, and there's no impact on the y. And for part B, now it's the opposite of what our brain wants. It's inside the argument of the function, so it's a horizontal stretch this time. What would we have to do to get back to x? Well, our new point, we'd have to multiply by 3. So we would have 3x and then y. Remember, inside the argument of the function is the x coordinate impact only. Let's have a look. Let's look and see what happens when we make b 2 and and this is going to be a horizontal compression. It's as though we've got those two bars pressing from the right and pressing from the left. Now we'll consider the horizontal stretch. We're going to make B about one third or 0.33. And you can see that that is a horizontal stretch, as though we got those two bars and we're stretching our graph out by three. Finally, we'll talk about reflections. So here I have a negative outside the argument of the function. So this is, if I change from a positive y to a negative y or a negative y to a positive y, this flips the graph over the x-axis. So outside the argument of the function, of course, it's just going to impact the y-coordinate. And remember, it's going to flip it over the x-axis. Now, if I have it inside the argument of the function, this is going to make a change. It's going to just impact the x-coordinate here. And if I go from left of the y-axis over to the right of the y-axis or vice versa, then that's going to flip or reflect horizontally over the y-axis. So let's look at a reflection over the x-axis. I'm going to make a negative 1, and you can watch how it flips over the x-axis here. And now we'll make B negative 1, and we'll watch the reflection across the y-axis. And there we can see the reflection across the y-axis. Let's put all this together with this example. We want to explain how the new function is related to the parent function y equals f of x, and then we'll look at what happens to a specific point. So when you're confronted with these problems, I want you to remember two things. X comes before y in the alphabet, do x first, and follow the order of operations. So for x inside the argument of the function, it's going to be a horizontal shrink because it's multiplied by 3. So remember, opposite land. So a horizontal shrink by 3, or you could say by 1 third. And then plus 1, how would we undo that? It would have to subtract 1, so it's to the left 1. So the x-coordinate's going to become, now here I want you to think about the order of operations. The x-coordinate is 1 third x, that will get you back from the 3x, minus 1. All right, now for outside the argument of the function, we have a vertical stretch. So a vertical stretch by 2. That's going to impact the y coordinate. And then minus 2 means it's down 2. So the y coordinate then will become 2y. It doesn't matter what you feed into f of x, that's just all y. Minus 2. So for part B, I'm going to have the point 0, 0. Well, that's going to become 1 third 0, or 0, minus 1. And the 0 for the y component will be 2 times 0, or 0, negative 2. Let's have a look. I would like to invite you to like this video and subscribe to this channel. Thanks very much for listening.